On Sports South, Rich Peverly and the Thrashers go head-to-head with Patrice Bergeron and the Boston Bruins. Thrashers, Bruins, Thursday at 7 on Sports South.
Welcome to College Flash Classics. I'm Bob Fisella. October 13th, 2001. Raleigh was the site for one of the wildest ACC games of the year as 16th-ranked Clemson traveled to Tobacco Road for a showdown with North Carolina State. Now, Chuck Amato's high-powered attack was led by sophomore sensation Philip Rivers, who 2 years later would be the fourth pick in the NFL draft. Meantime, Tommy Bowden's third-ranked Tigers team had an explosive offense whose unquestioned leader was multi-dimensional QB Woodrow Danzler. Now, the winner would get a leg up in the ACC race as both teams were 1-1 in the league. Let's go to Raleigh for the opening kickoff.
And it is Adam Kiker kicking off, the sophomore from Waynesboro, North Carolina, for the Wolfpack. And back to receive is Brian Mance and Joe Don Reeves. And we are just about ready to go. The Wolfpack and the Tigers, and this should be one of the better ones of the season. Mance, the leader in the ACC in return yards.
Deadly, deadly.
He's got it at the goal line. Mance, oh, shot it down.
Oh. Hello.
At the 19-yard line, it's a 19-yard gain, and that's where they'll start first and 10. And let's take a look at Woody Danzler, and what a year he is putting together. And, of course, needs just 57 yards to become the first ever ACC player to log 2,000 yards rushing and 4,000 yards in the air, and 65% in the air for Woody Danzler. On their own 19. First and 10. Here's Danzler out into the flats. It's complete to Hamilton. And Hamilton gets a first down up over the 30-yard line to the 31. Hamilton's a good-looking freshman, redshirt freshman from Dillon, South Carolina. And he is second among NCAA freshmen in receptions. Those are the backs and receivers for the Tigers.
Up front, they're really happy to have T.J. Watkins, who's starting for him. He was injured. That's a solid offensive line.
On first down, here comes a handoff, and it goes to Travis Zachary. And Zachary up to about the 35-yard line, brought down by D'Antonio Burnett, one of the leaders of that defensive core. And, of course, let's take a look at our Chevy starting lineups. And Corey Smith has forced 6 fumbles. That leads the NCAA. Terrence Martin, Darius Bryant, and George Anderson up front.
And we talk a lot about Fisher, and the whole country does that, but Jamerson and Burnett, those guys are very active at linebackers as well. And that secondary, Patterson, Holt,
offside,
and Washington,
defense,
they will have their hands filled today.
Offsides against NC State will back them up, or push them ahead, push Clemson ahead 5 yards to the 36-yard line.
Brian Williams is noted as the quiet killer. Torrey Holt gave him that nickname. He will definitely have to be that type today because against this offense at Clemson, there's so much coming at him.
And a lot of it out of the arm and the feet of Woodrow Danzler. He's back to throw. And Danzler complete. And it's ahead to Matt Bailey, and that's just around the 45-yard line, and it'll be good for another Clemson first down. That'll push him out 8 yards on the play.
Chuck Amato. I like Chuck. I mean, Chuck really represents what football is all about, especially college football. Enthusiasm.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line. There's the option. Danzler breaks a tackle, and he's into the secondary, and he's on his way. Woody Danzler all the way. Touchdown, Clemson.
In the first drive of the game, I think he scored a 55-yard touchdown run. And ironically, it was on an option, and they were running into a blitz where if you could have stopped the game and found out they were running the option, you would have called this blitz to stop it. And we had a guy with a kill shot on Danzler, and Danzler slipped out of the tackle, cut back across the field and outraced all of us to the end zone. And that was one of those where we said, uh-oh, we're in trouble.
He's special. That's why he's a Heisman candidate.
Aaron Hunt getting ready for the current app. Out of the hold of Jeff Scott. The kick is a low squibber, but it does the trick. And Clemson hits the board first. A 55-yard run by quarterback Woodrow Dantzler on a play that looked like it was going to break down. Leaves him 2 yards away from setting a standard that nobody's ever set in ACC history.
At the Ford year-end sales event, the excitement's in the air because the deals are in the showroom. Cars, trucks, SUVs, crossovers, they're all here. Fuel-efficient vehicles with quality that can't be beat by Honda or Toyota. Look, they're getting 0% financing right now. She's getting a great deal on a lease. And this guy? This guy's getting goosebumps. The Ford year-end sales event won't go on forever, so come on in today and get your own goosebumps and consider yourself officially invited to drive one.
Can you say FreeTripleScore.com 3 times fast?
FreeTripleScore.com, FreeTripleScore.com,
FreeTripleScore.com, FreeTripleScore.com.
What's FreeTripleScore.com?
FreeTripleScore.com, FreeTripleScore.com. Why is FreeTripleScore.com the best place to go get my credit score?
FreeTripleScore.com gives you all 3 credit reports and scores from the 3 top bureaus. And best of all, they're free when you try Privacy Matters 1, 2, 3.
Really get all 3 for free?
Why do I need to check all 3 of my credit reports and scores?
One credit report doesn't tell you the whole story.
You could have good credit on one report, and on the other 2, you could have harmful information that could keep you from getting a loan, and in some cases, keep you from getting a job.
Not knowing your credit score could be a big mistake.
I didn't know my credit score could keep me from getting a job.
Lenders look at all 3 credit reports, shouldn't I?
3 really is better than 1.
Where can I get all 3?
Where can I get all 3?
Where can I get all 3? Log on to FreeTripleScore.com where you can get 3 for free.
FreeTripleScore.com.
After a Wolfpack punt, we pick up the action as Clemson has a first down at the state 28-yard line.
First and 10 for the Clemson Tigers. Dantzler has the record now, the only ACC player with 2,000 yards rushing, 4,000 passing. On the reverse, here's the handoff to Corey, and Corey, Aris Corey, with a flag down on the play. Aris Corey, he's from Columbia, South Carolina, a true freshman.
How do you catch a breath on defense? Roger Pollard, the linebacker for NC State, gave up contain.
There's Woody Dantzler into history. Holding on the offense, 10-yard penalty.
Woody Dantzler had all these intangibles. Number 1, he's a winner. Number 2, he can really create when everything around him breaks down. And he learned to throw the ball well enough to keep defenses off balance. He was a real triple threat quarterback.
First down, actually about 12. On the spot of the hole, Dantzler out on the wing. Pass is dropped by Matt Bailey. Nobody around, just Matt and the ball.
Boy, Gary Bird, right tackle for the Clemson Tigers, did his job. And he engulfed Anderson at the point of attack, gave Clemson that corner. You can't allow the Tigers to get to outflank you.
I think one of the big factors why we had such a hard time was that Woody Dantzler was a quarterback, and they were running a type of single-wing spread offense. And he had a tremendous amount of yards in that game, and he kept the football away from us.
Number of injuries in his spot.
Lost at least 4 wide receivers, but they're very deep there. Big rush is on by Fisher, and down goes Woodrow Dantzler. Dantzler down at the 45 of NC State.
LeVar was an outstanding defensive player for us. He was the linebacker with the mentality that he had to make every tackle. He was a relentless pursuer of the football and had great speed and just was always after it and was always after the football, just like a heat-seeking missile.
Loss of 13 on the play. We'll bring up 3rd down. That's the 16th sack given up by the Clemson Tigers this season. Dantzler. Pressure is on, rolling over him is George Anderson, the junior from LaPorte, Texas.
Well, this was a good scheme, Steve Martin. They had the number count working for them.
NC State's defense, of course, was going to have a flavor of the Florida State package since Chuck Amato was the new coach at NC State now and was doing a great job. They were athletic and extremely fast, talented group.
That's a poor job up front. Great job on defense by Anderson.
Wynn Cobb to punt. And the pass. The snap is behind him. Cobb will fall on it, and NC State will get the football inside the Clemson 10.
And the Wolfpack crowd is alive. One of our keys, Steve Martin, was special teams for Clemson. And before we could even post it, they'd had a breakdown.
Breakdown on that play, and they give NC State excellent.
When we gave up a tremendous field position, when we muffed that punt, you know, you just tell the offense, hey, it's a long game. It's not a one-quarter ball game. It's a four-quarter ball game. Certainly, we knew we were going to have to score a lot of points because NC State's offense was extremely good as well. But that was the big thing. Nobody panic. Try to get that kicking game straightened out there in a hurry. And let's just go out there and stay with our game plan.
One in motion now. That's Peterson. Reverse comes to Peterson. Peterson tries to turn the corner, gets up inside. And it's going to be Thomas coming up with the tackle. Let's look at the Clemson starting lineups. Khalid Vaughn, 2000 Defensive Rookie of the Year, with McNeil Coleman, who's a true freshman, and DeJuan Pope.
Well, I talked about Leak. Jack Carson is a maniac. This guy is an outstanding player. We see a lot of him. Rodney Thomas already had a great play. Francis Mance, we've seen the speedster, and Meekins. Those guys will have their hands filled. Well, you see William Brown on that last play. The big guard couldn't get out front in time.
He's been hampered by an ankle injury. Pass going for the end zone. It is touchdown, Cottery.
With Phillip being so accurate in his passing, any skilled receiver that had any ability was always a threat. But with Jericho's ability in the open field, and with Phillip's accuracy, he was kind of an additional threat that we had to be careful for.
Score at home in a big game, following the turnover, boy, you talk about a swing of momentum.
The defense gave it to him. Here's Adam Kiker with a kick, and it is good. Adam Kiker with the point after touchdown, and it's just like the others that we've seen in this series. All tied up at 7-all with 7:43 left to go. We'll return after these messages from your local ACC station.
The SEC basketball now is a tradition. It's competitive, the best of the best. Perception-wise, it's football league. But I think you look at the fact of LSU's been to a Final Four recently. We've been to Final Fours recently. Kentucky's, you know, been to Final Fours. You look at the league and what everybody's done inside the league, it's really been remarkable. I think that this league for a long, long time has been as good as any league in the country.
You see them lead their teams into battle on Saturday. Now watch their shows on Sunday only on Sports South. South Carolina head coach Steve Spurrier kicks off the day of coaches at 11:30 Eastern, followed by Vols head coach Lane Kiffin at noon. And Mark Richt breaks down the Georgia Bulldogs Sunday afternoons at 1. Catch the Dan Mullen Show later that evening at 5:30. Sports South Sunday of Coaches shows wraps up with the Houston Nut Show at 6 o'clock Eastern. Sports South Sunday of SEC Coaches. It's happening here all season long.
You're watching Sports South.
Clemson fumbled on its next drive, and following a first down and then two holding penalties, the Wolfpack has the ball first and 30 on its own 46-yard line.
First down and actually 29.
Brian may not like it, but no.
Rivers back to throw. Pass is complete. This is Devontae Edwards, and Edwards gets very little yardage. Mance brings him down at the 50-yard line.
There's no doubt that Clemson, you know, had some great athletes, defensively, and
You know, we knew it was a big challenge for us, you know, with Rivers and our crew, because we knew that they, Clemson's always blessed with great athletes, and we knew it was a great challenge for our offense.
First quarter of that game. Second down and 24 for the Wolfpack. Score tied at 7. They picked up a fumble. Kind of got movement early.
Oh, that's smart. Go for it.
Throwing it out to Peterson.
Francis and Peterson, two alert players.
We knew in NC State with Phillip Rivers, our quarterback, it's not a matter of if he's going to get hot. It's going when he gets hot, he's tough to defend. Even though he was young, we knew we were in for a battle.
Defense, 5 yards, repeat the match.
So that changes first and 24 to first and 19. And coming up at halftime, we'll be taking a look at the Alltel halftime stats. So stay with us.
Start calling plays right now. What do you think I call?
Let's see, tight end, really right hand.
Some way you can touch on the right side. You're right, you got it.
Maybe next play. Ray Robinson, not much yardage there on the deep handoff. Clemson determined to stop the run, and a lot of people have dared NC State to run on them. Wake Forest did last year.
Clemson's always pretty good. Always have a pretty has a pretty good defensive football team. They're very athletic. Their guys can really run. They're very athletic. They play the 4-3 defense. Good strong secondary. The linebackers are always fast. They got good speed. They cover a lot of ground, and they present some problems because they are very athletic.
Rivers converted last time in similar situation. The pass is incomplete, but we have a flag down on the play.
I don't mind that incompletion. Throwing right into two receiver side, two defender side, rather. I like that incompletion because that would have been trouble.
Most of the time when our offense is off the field, we as a coaching staff, with Coach Bowden included, are discussing our next series of plays and what we're going to be running, what's working for us, looking at tendencies of the defense at this point in the ball game. You know, you see a little bit about what the other team's doing.
And one of them was, how are you?
Reggie's a good man, and the kids play for him. You know, a lot of guys know what they're doing, but they can't get the kids to follow through. Reggie didn't have that problem, and they communicate well. It's a close-knit group.
Well, he's had to face third down three times in this drive. This is third and 15. Rivers, pass time, pass intended for Peterson. Francis called for interference. This time the Wolfpack will get first down by penalty.
And there was some good pressure up front by the Tigers.
You know, a lot of times we were throwing the 5 yard, what we called scat routes and that type of thing. But it was more of a ball control thing for us. It was like a run for us, so we were throwing all those 5 yard scats and screens and that type of thing to try to control the clock and again keep Danzler off the field because he was awful dangerous with his feet.
And yelled at Brian Peterson a moment ago. He wants him to beat Francis. He said, "You can beat that guy. You can beat him." And it's obvious that on this series, they've thrown the number 2 several times. They really feel that they can beat Francis, number 26. He got called for pass interference there, but otherwise, he's been holding his own against a pretty good state receiver.
That's a great point, Mike. I was about to say, Francis has been all over this field. He's done a great job, and that's a tough call. I don't mind that. I don't mind that at all.
First and 10 for the Wolfpack. Clemson 24-yard line. Rivers hands off. Robinson stood up. And that was John Leak, who had the first hit. Sophomore from Plano, Texas, who leads this team in tackles with 54.
Well, he's a good one. That's what I was talking about in the open with Scott Kustra, left tackle for NC State. We may have to see more of Mr. Leak than he'd like. Here's another guy, just pure football player. The guy loves the game, worked on his body in the offseason, you know, added as much weight as possible, strong as an ox. Loves the game.
Second down and 10. Last three running plays, Doc, for NC State. No yardage.
Yeah, but you got to stay with it.
Here's the pitch. Robinson gets a little running room. The lead will pull him down at the 19-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play.
That's classic Ray Robinson. Not a lot happened there, but he made something of it. As long as he doesn't get discouraged, and it would probably be discouraging, but you wait on that run. If they hang in there with it, we've seen more so than not, you'll get one.
Miami with a 2-touchdown lead on Florida State in the first quarter.
Woo.
No Campbell.
They're good, though. Those kids good. Have the whole package.
And they got an axe to grind, too. Third down and 5.
Feel that dog?
Here it comes. Pass to the end zone. Cotchery, touchdown!
Rivers is a keeper. This kid is a keeper. Father high school coach, played quarterback for him. And boy, you talk about
the thing that I love about Phillip Rivers, he had 310 yards in this game, and everybody talks about the way he throws and that silly throwing motion. Hey, he gets it to the right guy at the right place, and the guy knows how to win. I really like Phillip Rivers.
What a play by Cotchery of 19. The kick by Tiger is good. Phillip Rivers has gotten it done and now stands third on the NC State quarterback list with his 32nd career touchdown pass. Obviously happy at this turn of events.
The gifts start here at Academy Sports and Outdoors. Give the men's or women's Nike T-Lite trainer a hot deal at just $29.99 at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
The right gifts, the low prices every day.
Come be a part of the 25th anniversary of the CVS Pharmacy Strong Legs Run, benefiting Children's Healthcare of Atlanta. Join us at Turner Field Saturday, November 14th for a day full of family fun. There will be runs for all ages, as well as a special CVS Pharmacy All Kids Can Race. Just stop by your local CVS Pharmacy to pick up a registration form. For more information, go to our website or call 404-785-7370. All funds will benefit Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
The gifts start here at Academy Sports and Outdoors. Get Disney 12 and 16-inch bikes from $59.99 to $69.99. A hot deal at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
The right gifts, the low prices every day. Academy.
Your Atlanta Hawks are back with a vengeance. Dwayne Wade is back to turn up the heat on the Hawks in Atlanta. Hawks, Heat, Wednesday at 7 in HD, only on Sports South.
Every time the puck hits the net at 100 miles per hour. See it on Sports South. Rich Peverly and the Thrashers go head-to-head with Patrice Bergeron and the Boston Bruins. Thrashers, Bruins, Thursday at 7 on Sports South.
NC State 14-7 over the Clemson Tigers. Clemson scored first, but two Jericho Cotchery touchdown pass receptions from Phillip Rivers as the Wolfpack up on top. Clemson playing in purple pants for the first time in their history.
There's Matt Bailey.
There's the pass, and it goes complete, and that's to the tight end. That's Ben Hall, the true freshman from Welford, South Carolina. We're told they'd worked on that a lot in practice going.
Woodrow Dantzler, I've seen a lot of good running, passing combination quarterbacks, but this kid was as good as I've ever seen because you didn't know what he was going to do next. He was an amazing player.
No huddle. Coaches look at the personnel, and then they flash the call into him. This is Hamilton, the freshman, and he is jolted as he goes out of bounds, but not before he gets to the 48-yard line. Gain of about 7 on the play.
Marcus Hudson is reckless.
To the sidelines, and Mike Hogwood. Second down and 3. Dantzler ahead, and Fisher helps bring him down, but he's got the first down, and he's in NC State territory at the 46.
Nice block by Rambert, too. The halfback. I mean, you get a fake, and then you come out of it and get a nice block. Might have hurt his wrist on that play. Know what that limp arm feels like, but it adds to his pain.
First and 10. Blitz is on, hand off Rambert. And Rambert goes up to the 40-yard line.
They were on the cutting edge. They had stumbled onto something, and they were the ones that were a little bit ahead of everybody else. And a lot of it centered on being in the shotgun and running the quarterback. out of the gun. And this was the year, they had Woody Dantzler as a quarterback. It was his first full year, I believe, as a starter. And he was an outstanding athlete, and he made that system go.
Receivers total. Kelby is the lone receiver to the top side. Looking over there, the screen to Zachary. Zachary, wide receiver screen, and he gets the first down at the 25-yard line. Flag down on the play, however.
Power sweep. I'm gonna call that a power sweep.
Yeah.
Hey, man, you get three guys in front of you. I don't care who they are. When you get Zachary with the ball carry, it's a power sweep.
It's a hold against Clemson. We've had 12, at least 12 penalties in this first half.
Good design. Boy, Brad Scott, the coordinator for the Tigers, this is what you want, but inside maybe a little grab. And it's hard not to.
Spot foul, repeat for that. So that'll push the ball back toward the 47-yard line, which is the original line of scrimmage for this drive.
Steve, when you have to contain a skilled athlete in space that long, you almost better maybe a little butt and then cut the guy at the end.
Second down. Three wide receivers out. Ball handoff goes to Zachary, and Zachary stood up. Antonio Burnett right there.
The thing that impressed us was their aggressiveness, their way they chased the football, took on the personality of certainly of their coaches and coaching staff. So. You know, we felt like that what we were going to have to do is a lot of misdirection plays, a lot of ways to, you know, feature Woody Dantzler. But we thought it would be a team that we could take advantage of their aggressiveness. And as it turned out, that was probably the difference in the ball game, that and a quarterback for us named Woody Dantzler.
They need somebody to come up with a big play.
The upper slot. Hamilton's inside his shoulder, rolling that way. Dantzler looking over the middle of the field. Incomplete from McKelvey. Brian Williams covering on the play, but a flag is down.
The thing that Chuck Amato brought to NC State was instant credibility from all those years at Florida State. He upgraded the recruiting right away, got down into Florida where they needed more speed players, and he raised the overall profile of the program right away.
Such interference against NC State. Williams there a shade too early. And that gives Clemson a first down at the Wolfpack 30-yard line. Have had how many penalties? 13.
See, that's tough. I might just well give Brian a high five on that and say, man, keep covering him like that.
I mean, two teams combined, we've had about 13. That's the fifth on NC State. Play fake, Dantzler to throw, pass complete. That's his tight end, Hall. And he's down to the 10-yard line, a gain of 20.
Unstoppable. Big, smart guys running across the field, making catches.
Chuck Amato is a defensive guy. He was always a defensive coach. And this defense was struggling, and Amato was really, really frustrated on the sidelines.
Can't even contain it.
Can't contain it. All of it.
Tight end gets 20. Dantzler back to throw. Blitz is on, trying to get after it. Pass complete. Touchdown, Hamilton.
Hamilton, obviously, at that time, I think, was a sophomore and was beginning to show that he was going to be a very dependable receiver and also a guy that was a great runner after the catch. And we featured him on several plays in that ball game, and, you know, he caught some critical plays. I think one of our early touchdown passes was a throw to him across the middle of the field down in the red zone. He came down with that ball, and certainly he was a weapon.
Here's Aaron Hunt out of the hold of Jeff Scott, son of Brad Scott, offensive coordinator. There comes the kick, and it is good. So the Clemson Tigers come back and tie it up. Woodrow Dantzler hooks up 10 yards downfield to Derek Hamilton. And we've got a tie ball game with 9:47 left to go in the second.
Brick by brick. Stone by stone, we built a place to call our own. gonna fill it up with laughter, write my happy ever after. 'Cause for the first time in my life, I'm holding the key to a brand new life waiting on me. That's what makes a house a home. Across the country and around the world, thousands of Habitat homeowners and millions of volunteers know the joy and pride of seeing a house become a home. A brighter future, one family at a time. Support Habitat's work in your community. Volunteer, get involved, and help build it. Visit Habitat.org. That's what makes a house a home.
SoCon Saturday is on Sports South. The Appalachian State Mountaineers head to Elon to battle the Phoenix. Appalachian State, Elon. Tomorrow at 3, only on Sports South. Brought to you by BB&T.
First and 10 from the 25-yard line. Woody Dantzler has four wideouts, actually three wideouts and a wing to the same side. Dantzler ignores all of them and takes his own number, and that's a pretty good number to call. Burnett will drive him out of bounds at the 44-yard line. It's a gain of 19 on the play.
Now you go back to the Georgia.
If we could use Woody as a running back, fake to our normal running back, then that gave us the advantage of having an extra blocker and really a tailback in our quarterback with Woody. In that particular ball game, we did a lot of that.
Here comes Dantzler again. Fakes the throw. Gets a nice block on the corner and is driven into the NC State bench, and there's going to be a flag. Hudson with the hit after he was clearly out of bounds. 5-yard gain, but it'll be more with the yardage after the play.
Well, I'll tell you what, Phil Smith had an outstanding job of trying to string this along, blocking up front. I mean,
personal foul, played here in the defense, 15 yards, first half.
Dantzler's outstanding. I want you to see 61 in there. Watch him. He's trying to get out here. This is his space. This is a big guy. Watch his footwork. Pins inside. And that's a good football player. He is taken completely out of the play. And then the rest is Dantzler. And that, folks, is a late hit.
Zachary is loaned back. Four wide receivers out. Three left, one right. Fake draw. Dantzler gets around and is driven out of bounds there by Pollard and Peterson.
You could put Woody at any position, quarterback, receiver, running back. I mean, at that time, it's kind of like basketball on the field. We had so many offensive weapons, but at the same time, we had just an explosive quarterback. So, I mean, everybody keyed in certain offensive guys, but kind of forgot about Woody. Then they started keying in on Woody, but Woody just made plays every down that he could.
It's huffing and puffing because they're trying to catch this guy.
Second and six coming. Inside the 8-yard line.
This is Fisher time. This is the time he usually makes a big play.
Rolling left and bearing down, passing right, tight end, Hall, touchdown.
Oh my goodness.
7-yard grab by Ben Hall, his first career touchdown reception. It was a play that Clemson had worked on this week, throwing across the field to the tight end with Dantzler setting up to the other side.
Big Ben, his third reception in this ball game. You're right, the action of the play, that sold it. Then the great talent, Ben Hall, sealed the deal.
Tight ends caught three big passes for Clemson.
They're awesome.
Here's Hunt, kick is up and it is straight down the uprights.
NC State coaches felt Woodrow Dantzler was his most dangerous when he got outside the pocket. You had to keep him in the pocket. When this guy started ad-libbing and making up plays on his own, he was unbelievable.
We'll come through in the clutch.
North Carolina State ended the half by kicking a 20-yard field goal as time expired, cutting the Tigers' lead to 21-17. We will be right back with the second half action.
I'd like to show you the most versatile bag on the market today. The Soft Super Cooler.
It's a waterproof lined bag with super insulation.
Pop the water seal like that. Put your clothes in it. Go on vacation. Unpack. Now you have a cooler, a day bag. Two ends of the bag, they pop open like this. Heavy-duty YKK zippers never rust or bind. The same zippers they have in wetsuits. They'll never rust on you. This opens up here. Mesh pocket there. Plates, knives, forks, tackle boxes, anything you want to put in here for storage, even a beach blanket.
You can even crush it down for easy storage.
Drop the whole bag in the water, it floats.
The whole liner pulls out for easy cleaning.
The money I save on ice is amazing.
Call 1-800-871-7289 and get the Soft Super Cooler and Deluxe Shoulder Strap for just $69.95, plus processing and handling. You'll also get the incredible reusable TechniIce free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Ask about the larger Deluxe Soft Super Cooler and optional hand cart. Order now.
The Soft Super Cooler, the most versatile bag in the world.
Big 12 football on College Football Saturday. Jared Johnson and Texas A&M collide with Oklahoma in a crucial battle with bowl implications. College Football Saturday this week, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors.
Welcome back to Carter-Finley Stadium as Sitco presents ACC football. It's 21-17 Clemson, and they have the ball at their own 46-yard line. Woodrow danced a pass complete to his freshman. That's Derek Hamilton, and he's out just beyond the 50-yard line down to the 47-yard line of NC State. 13:38 left to go. It's going to be a gain of seven, and we want to bring into the booth an old friend of ours, Coach Bill Dooley, joining us here in the broadcast booth. And ACC legend, that is indeed true. He's coached at Wake Forest, at North Carolina, Virginia Tech, and has joined us up in the broadcast booth on numerous occasions. Good to have you on board.
Well, it's great to be here, Steve, with you and Doc, and y'all do a great job. And we've got a whale of a football game going on today.
We keep that yellow flag in somebody's pocket, it'd be even better.
Well, it's flag day here at Carter-Finley. That guy right there is unbelievable.
Woodrow danced.
He can make a miss him.
How would you stop him, Coach?
Well, hey, the only way you can stop him is to get two or three.
We felt like we needed to continue to do the things we were doing offensively. We had moved the ball fairly well, and Woody Dancer was creating some pretty big plays offensively. So let's continue to do that, get the ball in his hands, and see if we can generate some offense in the second half.
Dancer just eludes a tackler, throws complete to the flats, and a flag is thrown. That pass is, yep, that
came
pass,
in late.
Marvin Jenkins gets the catch. There's Buddy Green. Gee, he's seen enough of the flag, too.
Ball. Late hit. On the defense, 15 yards, first down.
We want to develop a game plan, certainly, that would feature Woody and take advantage of NC State's athleticism and over-aggressive pursuit to the football, you might say, on defense. But a very well-coached team, so, and we're playing on the road.
He can run it. He can beat you in a lot of different ways. But I like the quarterback on the other side, too, Phillip Rivers. He's an outstanding football player.
Young sophomore with a lot of points.
First and 10 after the penalty. Dancer looking for the corner. Zachary wide open. Touchdown, Clemson. Nobody in the world covering Travis Zachary.
It was just one of those days where Dancer was on fire, running it and then throwing it as well. And I think when we look back after the game, I think, I think they had like 300 of their yards came on seven plays. They were just explosion plays. They were big plays given up by us, which is one of the mantras of any great defense is you can't give up the big play. And they just ripped us with them on that day.
Here comes Aaron Hunt for the point after. Kick is up and it is good. Crowd of 50,000, with the exception of maybe 1,002 Clemson fans, trying to get themselves back into this game. Second down and 15. Dantzler pass complete to Zachary. Zachary down the middle of the field, jukes away from Patterson and is brought down at the 12-yard line. Now down to the six.
Well, Doc, what a quarterback! This guy can beat you every way. He can throw it, he can run it, and the good.
Well, I think that was kind of a game that really gave him a lot of national prestige. What he had been fairly consistent for a couple weeks in a row, but I think this performance with over 500 yards total offense, he really jumped on the radar.
Sword on this one.
First and goal at the seven. After the 43-yard hookup with Zachary, this has been Zachary's featured drive. This time he loses yardage to the 9. Actually, the 8, a loss of 1 on the play, but he's had some big yardage this particular series downfield.
George Anderson comes in with another big play for the Wolfpack. They need to be energized.
Dantzler, 18 of 21, 207 yards. At one point, it hit 10 consecutive passes and has 3 touchdowns on the day.
And that's just half of his game.
That's right. Looking at second down and goal from the 8. Dantzler, gonna run. Dantzler, touchdown. 22nd time in his career he's had a rushing touchdown. And Clemson pushes the score to 34-17.
I think they'll keep these purple pants a little longer, guys.
Well, you talk about a guy that makes things happen.
It still comes down to tackling the man with the ball. Like when you were kids and you're playing in the front yard and there was one kid that nobody could lay a hand on. And that's what it was like that day. I mean, you could, you know, there wasn't a defense that we could get into if your 11 guys can't tackle the man with the ball. And
him out of there, and Dantzler walked in. Aaron Hunt, the point after touchdown, and that makes it 35-17. Woodrow Dantzler heads to the end zone, gets some help from his blockers. In for the score. We'll return after these messages.
The SEC basketball now is a tradition. It's competitive, the best of the best, perception-wise. It's football league. But I think you look at the fact of LSU's been to a Final Four recently. We've been to Final Fours recently. Kentucky's, you know, been to Final Fours. You look at the league and what everybody's done inside the league, it's really been remarkable. I think that this league for a long, long time has been as good as any league in the country.
You see them lead their teams into battle on Saturday. Now watch their shows on Sunday only on Sports South. South Carolina head coach Steve Spurrier kicks off the day of coaches at 11:30 Eastern, followed by Vols head coach Lane Kiffin at noon. And Mark Riff breaks down the Georgia Bulldogs Sunday afternoons at 1. Catch the Dan Mullen Show later that evening at 5:30. Sports South Sunday of Coaches shows wraps up with the Houston Nut Show at 6 o'clock Eastern. Sports South Sunday of SEC Coaches. It's happening here all season long.
You're watching Sports South.
First and 10 NC State, and they're starting from their own 10. Phillip Rivers out under center. Two wide receivers out. Raven Robinson in his backfield. Three-step drop, short pass complete to Cotchery. He's driven out of bounds at the 15, now the 17 and 18 yard line. So it's a gain of 8 on the play.
I would say, Coach Dooley, you look for something now, and you're Coach Amato. You have to get something positive for your club. What do you say to him?
Well, the only thing you can do is try to get something established in the running game and take some of the pressure off Phillip Rivers as a quarterback, because the only thing you can go to right now is throwing the football. Get something going running and get them off your back right here.
Here comes Raymond.
There he goes. That's what you got to do right there, Doc. And you got to establish the running game.
Meekins pulls him down. First and 10 at the Clemson 22. Here comes the fake reverse. Peterson's got it. Got a man wide open. Touchdown. What a play fake by Bryce.
We didn't feel we could run a power offense against these guys, and basically that was our offense. I mean, to spread it out a little bit more, and we wanted to run the draw play, run the trap play, run our scat series against them, and then run some throws down the field.
And NC State certainly did that.
Well, they didn't fake our camera guys out, and that took a lot because they had all of us going.
Peterson did a beautiful job selling the fake, and Cotchery caught his third touchdown of the day. The point after, however, by Kiker is wide to the right. And off to Rembert. Sweet, nice block by Zachary, and Rembert gets to midfield. It's a gain of about 6 on the play, maybe 7.
You know, one of the impressive things, Steve, has been the versatility of the Clemson offense. They come at you every different way imaginable. I mean, it's runs, passes, reverses, everything.
Dantzler makes it work. He's under center this time. He's been in shotgun most of the day. Here comes Zachary, and Zachary, wide hole right up the middle. He's got another Clemson first down at the 44-yard line. To the sidelines we go with Mike Hogwood.
Yeah, I was talking with Rodney Williams, former Clemson quarterback, now on the radio network here on the sidelines, and he says the big difference in Woodrow Dantzler now and even a couple of weeks ago is his vision, how he keeps his head up throughout the whole play and checks out all his options before tucking it down and running. Doc mentioned maturity earlier. I think vision has a part of that maturity.
First and 10 from the NC State 43. Here's the reverse to Curry, but Collar will have none of it. He slows him up, and finishing him off is George Anderson.
Discipline.
Nice play, Roger Collar.
Yeah, discipline defense.
Burnett helped out on the play.
You get so caught up in your own play, meaning the offensive plays, scheming, what plays you're going to call next, field position certainly is a factor in all of that. But we just felt like we needed to stay one score ahead of them, whether that meant we needed to score five times or three times. It didn't really matter.
10th play of a drive that started at the Clemson 7-yard line. Dantzler back to throw. Now thinks better of it, and again, NC State misses a tackle. And there he goes. Woody Dantzler, another broken tackle.
I don't believe it.
And Pollard, I believe, finally comes back to get him, but not before Dantzler, who should have been down at the 45-yard line, makes his way all the way down to the 7, 43 yards later. Second and goal from the 4. Play fake, Dantzler, pass complete, touchdown. And he hits Chad Jasmine, his fullback. A 4-yard touchdown.
Philip Rivers and Woody Dantzler were exact opposites on the field. Rivers, the prototype dropback guy. Dantzler, the mobile, scrambling quarterback. Woody Dantzler and Philip Rivers had one thing in common. They were both leaders, and both of them had the respect of their teammates. All their teammates believed that each of those guys could lead their team to victory.
Here comes Aaron Hunt out of the hold of Jess Scott for the point after. Kick is up and it is good.
On its next drive, State was forced to punt, but Clemson fumbled the kick and the Wolfpack recovered. After a pass interference penalty, NC State has the ball first down on the Clemson 24-yard line.
First and 10 at the 24-yard line. Robinson back in the tail. Edwards is the slot for Graham on that side, and Cotry is split wide out on the left. Looking right at Cotry, pump and goal. Cotry end zone, out of bounds. Haefeli covering all the play for Clemson.
They can do that because of the scoreboard and because of very little threat to run.
Right.
Play action, pump. You know, NC State can't abandon their offensive game plan. You know, with 14:08 to go in the ballgame, they still have time.
19 points back. That's technically three scores.
Fellas on the 24-yard line, second down.
And Miami is going to end the long win streak of Florida State at Doak Campbell. 49-20 in the third. The Textile Bowl here being played out in Raleigh. NC State trying to get back in this one. Rivers has time, comes out of the pocket. Throws behind the line of scrimmage. It's to Graham at the 12. Graham put that football dangerously out there to try to get more yardage. It's a 12-yard gain, and it brings up another first down.
Very mature for his age. You just very, you know, in at least in 28 years I've been coaching, have not seen a guy that young be that composed and assume the leadership of a team and then watch a team conform to his temperament and his personality as a young guy.
Quarterback Olin Hannon, backup quarterback, is in the play, and now Eason. Actually, no, that's Donnell Washington. And Javon Bush as they sandwich Philip Rivers for a loss of 2 on the play.
Boy, that's unfair. You get Bush and Washington.
Yeah.
To hit you at the same time, you are in a world of trouble. I mean, that's a lot of manhood there. 600 plus pounds.
There's Javon Bush, fifth year senior out of Hardeeville, South Carolina.
He's played a lot of plays.
Yep.
A lot of plays.
So has Donnell Washington. Second down. Rivers throwing for the end zone. Has Peterson. Was he in?
That's
Was he in? Yes! Oh, man. Booster moves over to the opposite tackle. Robinson in motion. Rivers rushes on. Rivers gets out of the grasp of one, but throws it incomplete. Great pressure by Bryant McNeil. He was all over Phillip Rivers.
Kooster moved over. They made it a strong side. Nobody blocked anybody.
But Brian Peterson found himself on the successful end. Just enough real estate in the end zone to catch that one. His sixth catch, 120 yards, and his first touchdown of the day.
Before you ever love it, the Nissan Altima goes through over 5,000 tests. No wonder J.D. Power and Associates ranked it highest in initial quality. The new Nissan Altima, quality you can love.
This is a special announcement. The public is entitled to purchase cars and homes seized by police and bank agents. An inventory of cars and homes are available now and will be sold to the public. Call 800-729-8407. Cars available from $500. Homes available from $199 a month. Down payment assistance available for those who qualify. For listings in your area, call 800-729-8407. That's 800-729-8407.
Your Atlanta Hawks are back with a vengeance. Dwayne Wade is back to turn up the heat on the Hawks in Atlanta. Hawks. Heat, Wednesday at 7 in HD, only on Sports South.
And NC State will go without a huddle here. Second down and six. He'll pass over the middle to the tight end, Wright. And Wright has it up to the 44-yard line. That's a nice gain of 10 yards on the play. Picks up the first down.
That new wrinkle? We haven't seen that.
Kind of thought we'd see more of Willie Wright on the receiving end.
Yeah, I did.
It was one of the keys.
It's one of our keys.
Pass complete, Devontae Edwards. Edwards, make a miss tackles, and he's in Clemson territory at the 38-yard line. It's an 18-yard gain. So State trying to drum something up and get up field.
Well, if you watch State football, you know they don't quit. They don't have it in them.
Come from behind. 8 of their 11 wins under Chuck Amato. Here comes Rivers again. This one's complete to right.
Done a heck of a job too with those receivers. We talked about that, and with the injuries.
First and 10. Rivers with time. Oh, yeah. Almost picked off by Hafley. Overthrew Brian Peters.
Overshot. Hafley, he's had his hands failed as well. Rivers wants it. Kind of threw that across the body. I don't know if that's the footwork he wanted, but then again, he was under a bit of pressure.
A bit.
Yeah, just a little bit.
It's done a good job trying to get to him. They've sacked him three times this afternoon. Second down.
They can do it with the D line, too. That's what's impressive about the Tigers.
Rolling left. Rivers throws, and this one's low. John Leak in coverage of Brian Peterson that time, and that brings up third down. Stops the clock with 3:55 left to go. State has all of their timeouts left. And there's Rivers on the day. Not a bad day. 287 yards, three scores. Just thrown an interception. Looking for his sixth career 300-yard day. Third down and 10. Rivers up the middle. Gets rid of one tackler, but won't get the first down. He's pulled down at the 23-yard line. It's a gain of five on the play. It'll bring up fourth down and five. All right, fourth down and five for NC State. It all is right here. They're going to come back and do this thing. They just might. At the 16-yard line, first down, Jericho Cotchery, and he has had a lot of damage done in his direction today. Three touchdowns and a key first down on a 12-yard pickup.
Cotchery's quite a weapon in the red area. Plus 20, he has been very difficult to contain.
That's his sixth catch of the day. He's had three touchdown catches. Rivers on first down, throwing for the end zone, overthrows Hicks, the intended receiver. He was open, but
now Robinson missed his block right at the point. They tried to seal that in, and Ray couldn't get it done. Too much pressure on Phillip Rivers. That was a touchdown.
Yep.
That's the thing about college football and pro football as well. Running backs have a lot of responsibilities in terms of pass game, run game, blitz pickup, and run blocking.
Right.
It's not just toting the mail.
That's right. Four wideouts. Trey Jackson in with Jera Rivers. Steps up, fires. Oh, incomplete. Intended for Devontae Edwards and Chad Carson, and Eric Meekins held a meeting over his helmet.
Meekins, he delivers the blow. I like the way the kid finishes. Attitude with him.
He's got an interception already today.
You can't play at Clemson. They don't hide people. Everybody on their defense has to bring the hammer.
They got a lot of youngsters, freshmen, true freshmen, and redshirt freshmen on there, two deep. And they're all playing very well here today. Third down and 10. NC State down to the 16-yard line of Clemson. 16 points back. Pass complete to Raymond Robinson. Ray gets up to about the 12, maybe to the 11. 5-yard gain. It brings up fourth down again. I doubt that. He's such a hard worker, and for a good reason. Here's Rivers. Back to throw, fourth down. Pass complete. Touchdown, Willie Wright. 12-yard touchdown strike. And NC State closes in.
Boy, tight ends have played a huge part in today's ball game. All kidding aside, this young man here has a bright future. You know, as well as the young freshman, Ben Hall, that we've witnessed from Clemson.
Former wide receiver. Two-point conversion coming here for NC State. They're 10 points back. They want to close to within eight. Potchery in motion. Here comes Rivers to throw. Pass complete. Robinson. Got it!
Boy, Rodney Thomas is hot. Thought he had it.
Now, after the onside kick failed, there was no time left for NC State as Clemson ran out the clock to preserve a 45-37 win. The hero, Woodrow Dantzler, who accounted for 517 yards and six touchdowns. Clemson would go on to give Tommy Bowden his first postseason win as a head coach, while the Wolfpack righted the ship to finish the regular season with seven wins and earn a trip to the Tangerine Bowl. I'm Bob Pacella. Please join us next time on College Flash Classics.
Manning, Kyler, touchdown!
And that's exactly what they want to do, the pass, touchdown! Howard up the middle.
Every time the puck hits the net at 100 miles per hour. See it on Sports South. Rich Peverly and the Thrashers go head-to-head with Patrice Bergeron and the Boston Bruins. Thrashers, Bruins, Thursday at 7 on Sports South.
I guess you see basketball now as a tradition. It's competitive, the best of the best, perception-wise. It's football league. But I think you look at the fact of LSU's been to a Final Four recently. We've been to Final Fours recently. Kentucky's, you know, been to Final Fours. You look at the league and what everybody's done inside the league, it's really been remarkable. I think that this league for a long, long time has been as good as any league in the country.
Big 12 football on College Football Saturday. Jared Johnson and Texas A&M collide with Oklahoma in a crucial battle with bowl implications. College Football Saturday this week, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors.
SoCon Saturday is on Sports South. The Appalachian State Mountaineers head to Elon to battle the Phoenix. Appalachian State, Elon. Tomorrow at 3, only on Sports South. brought to you by BB&T.
I am change. People tell me I can be anything. A doctor, a lawyer, anything. But for the next year, this is my office. This is my day, and this is who I am. I am change, and this is where I belong.
You're watching Sports South.
This week on Eastern Golf with Todd Siddall.